Hi guys, I wanted to do another update for you. Quite a few people have been asking, can I do one? I'm sorry it's taken so long. It's just been a manic 3 months. So at the 1 year post-transplant, we decided that we needed to move house because it was getting really difficult for me to get in and out. I don't know if you remember me saying on the last video that I wasn't going out that much. So we found a place to rent, we sold our place, but there was a lot of packing to do, as you can imagine. Everything crammed into a one bed flat wasn't easy. So I was doing a lot of packing, I was really stressed out. I was also really worried about going to a new place. Had to organise getting a stair lift in because we moved to a house as opposed to a flat. So I needed to know when the stair lift was going to go in, when the bed was going to go. Are we going to move and then have to sleep down on the sofa bed until the stair lift comes? There's all these things going through my head. I remember having a bit of a panic attack the day I had to leave the house. Started getting anxiety. I was all of a sudden really worried. How am I going to adapt to the new place? How am I going to manage everything? The bath was different, just the area, the surroundings, it was just all difficult. I didn't have handrails put in before I moved in, so I was like, how am I going to get up the stairs? Just loads of things, and I remember crying the day I left, thinking, oh my God, I don't know what I'm going to do, I'm a bit scared. So that was in October that we moved. Managed to organise everything, get everything in at the same time. The stair lift went in the day after, or I think it went in the same day actually. So we had the people come in and put the bed in the morning, and then in the afternoon they came and did the stair lift, which was perfect because I tried to get up the stairs once without the stair lift and it was a nightmare. It was the scariest thing I've had to do for a long while. So yeah, once the stair lift went in, I was a happy bunny. The bed was there, didn't need to sleep on the sofa bed. So yeah, then again, there's a lot of unpacking to do and we were living out of boxes, and it's just difficult because when you're unable to do a lot of things, you're always having to rely on other people. My mum and my sisters, they were great. They came over, they helped me unpack. But there was just still loads, so I was doing like one or two boxes a day. My hubby did quite a bit. But yeah, everything worked out. I think it took me about a week to settle in. I asked my Facebook friends on the MS groups and they were like, it's normal to feel like this. You'll be fine. You will settle. Let us know how it goes. So I got a lot of support, which was great. So that was at the 1 year post. And then I was in November. So I'm going to fast forward now to Christmas. We all got sick. I had a cough and a cold. I don't think it was flu, but it kind of left me bedbound for 2 days. Luckily, I've got an ensuite bathroom now, so it wasn't too far to walk, but my mum had to kind of come round and help me and kind of pick my legs up to make sure that I can get into the bathroom. Hubby was at work in the evening, so it's proving to be a bit difficult. I think I took about 3 weeks to recover. So in all that time, which is probably about 3 months now, the physio had gotten less and less. I did try to keep up with a little bit, but nothing like I was doing back at the flat. So obviously you can imagine that the health was deteriorating a little bit and I was struggling to kind of get about. I'm now at 15 months post-transplant, and I've gotten back into the swing of doing regular physio, looking after myself, eating properly. So I'm hoping that I will start to feel a lot better. There's a couple of aids that I want to get, in that there's a bike that you can use. You kind of wheel up your chair or your wheelchair up to the bike, strap your legs in, and then you do the exercises. I'll tell you more about that later. So I've got something that kind of moves your feet back and forward. I've also started, I mentioned in my last video where I was doing, I was going to see a chiropractor. So he's kind of been working on my neck and my posture and aligning it. So I think that may be contributing to walking a bit better. I have days where I'm pretty good and the feet lift up and everything, and then there's days where my feet just swing out and drag to the side. Yeah, it's just one of those strange things with MS, good and bad. It's constantly up and down, so you just take it on the chin and just get on with things. As you can see, after a year and a bit, my hair has started to grow through. It's come back really thick actually, so I'm quite pleased with it. It does need a little trim, but I'm trying to grow it out. It's got that, it's at that horrible stage that it's not too short, it's not too long, and it just does whatever it wants in the morning. It looks a bit hideous. There's not much else to say apart from I feel okay. I've got an MRI coming up hopefully soon. It's been requested by my nurse. So yeah, hopefully that will show that there's no new lesions and that it's been working for me. Again, I still think it's too early to tell whether it's worked or not. The main thing is that I haven't got any worse than I was before I went. I mentioned before that I got sepsis before I went for my transplant, which gave me quite a bad relapse, and I haven't really ever recovered from that. But I think with a bit of hard work and exercise, I should be able to get there. So watch this space. And I will keep you updated again very soon. If you'd like to know more about my progress and receive updates, please like and subscribe to my channel. And I'll speak to you real soon. Bye for now.